Hello and welcome back to your 34th Django tutorial. In today's tutorial, we're going to go ahead and build our finish building our newsletter for the back end or the control panel that will allow us to send newsletters out to our users. So let's get started. Go ahead and open up your forms.py file in your newsletter app. All right, so here we need to first import our model. So newsletter is our model, right? And now this is going to be a pretty simple form. We might have to extend it later, but from what I'm thinking right now, it should be pretty simple. So class, and then we're going to do newsletter creation form. And then we'll do forms.modelForm. All right. And then we'll just do class meta. And in here we'll do model is equal to newsletter. And we'll just set fields. So fields with an S. And then in a list, do subject. I think we call it body, email, and status are the fields we want. So that's a pretty simple form compared to up here. We could clean data if you wanted to. I'm not too concerned about that because we're passing it ourselves. So we'll just leave it at that for now. Let's just get this running and make sure it works. Let's go to open your views.py file. And first things first, we need to import our models and our form. So newsletter and then newsletter creation form. There we go. And we're going to create a new view down here. And we called that control_newsletter. So create the function control_newsletter. And we just need to pass request. All right. So first things first, we're going to call the form if it's request.post or none. So we'll just do form is equal to newsletter creation form and then request dot post or none. All right, let me move this up just in case like an ad is blocking that or something. There we go. Then we're gonna say if form is valid. So if form dot is _valid, we're going to do something. Now, in the previous view that we did, which was unsubscribe, we did instance form.save commit to false. And then we ran a couple checks, and then we saved the form somewhere. Where did we save it? Oh, we didn't have to save it. We're deleting here. But anyway, we ran a couple checks and we'd save it. When you're working with many-to-many fields, we cannot actually grab the data from the save function like we were doing in the previous views because the many-to-many field needs an ID. So what we're going to do is instead, we're just going to go ahead and save it. Instance is equal to form. Save. Now, if I was if a user was doing something on the front end, I'd be a little more concerned. I'd probably run some kind of check, but not on the many field. All right. But since we're using it in the back end, we know how it functions, which should be fine. So let's do. So we do instance.save. So we're saving the data right to the database. Then we're going to do newsletter is equal to newsletter dot objects dot get, and then we're going to say id is equal to instance dot id. All right, so here's another field. We're getting the instance ID, which is actually passed from the save function. And what we're doing is we need to get the ID of the object that was just saved into our database, because we need to grab this object itself, because that's what we're sending, right? So we do ID. I guess you could do primary key as well, or you could do it by search for the title, but I think ID is our best option. All right, so that's what we're going to do. Then we're going to say if newsletter dot status is equal to published. All right, so if our newsletter status is equal to publish, we're going to do something. All right, So if it's not equal to to publish, this is just going to be skipped, and it shouldn't be published with an ED. It should just be publish. All right, then we're going to... Let's say we'll come back and do that. Let's do subject is equal to newsletter dot subject. All right, so now we're getting the subject that our email needs. Let's do body is equal to newsletter dot body. Let's do from underscore email is equal to settings dot email underscore host underscore user, and then we're going to say for. So now we're going to loop through all the emails. So in our form, which you guys haven't seen yet, we'll see it here in a couple seconds. Our email. We'll have a box that we can highlight all the emails we want to send it to. So I guess we could configure it differently if you wanted to, but I think this is the best option for us. So we're just going to loop through each email instead of sending a mass email that Django has a function for. If you send a mass email, you're going to have CC everything, all the users, which is not an option. So let's go ahead and just do for email in newsletter dot email. And when you're working with many and many field, we got to do all. All right. So we're going to get the emails, all of them, and we're going to loop through them and send an email separately for each one. All right. So we can do send mail. And we're just going to pass subject is equal to subject from underscore email is equal to from email. Recipient list is equal to a list and an email. And a message. Body. And fail silently is equal to true. All right, there we go. And let's come down to under this if statement, and we'll just put context is equal to form and form, and then our template. So template is equal to control underscore panel forward slash control newsletter.html, And then we're just going to do return render request template and context. All right. With that being said, we should be good to go check out. Well, no, we're not good to go check out our stuff yet. So go open up your control newsletter. We need to put the newsletter in here. Since we're going to use Crispy Forms, we need to load those tags. So load Crispy _ Forms _ tags. We'll add them in. And I don't even know why I'm keeping this around, but we will keep it there. Under this, let's go ahead and do form method is equal to post. Then after that, we need to do our CSRF cross-site forgery tag CSRF _ token. There we go. And then we're going to go ahead and add our form variable, form, and Crispy. And then we need a button down here, too. Button is equal to class BTN, BTN default. And in here, we need a type as well. So type submit, and we'll just say save. All right. Hopefully, this all works. We'll do Python manage.py run server. I'm going to throw my email address in here real quick, so we'll do the sign up. What the hell? No module name newsletter. Okay. Newsletters. This should be newsletters with an S. Circular import where module is not. Control panels, URLs. Doesn't appear to have any patterns in it. What the hell? This is what happens when you try to do things really fast. URL patterns. That should not be an S there. There we go. Circular. Let's check my code real quick. Oh, there we go. Now she wants to run. There we go. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put my personal email address in here so we can access it. So I can test it by sending myself an email. Cool. And now we're going to change the URL to control/ newsletter. newsletter. It's very important to not upload this to Django, or up to Heroku right now. Crap, we didn't set the CSS. Awesome. But there's our body, so we gotta go set the CSS in our control base. And the easiest way to do this is open your base.html. I knew I was forgetting something. Too easy. We're gonna copy all this right here. Right there. Copy that. Go to control base. Find all your CSS files. Come down to here. Paste them in. And I have to end this HTML comment. There we go. And then down here, open up your base again, all the way down to the bottom. We'll copy the JavaScript here. Copy this down here. Paste that in. Save it. Go back and refresh. This should work, I hope. We didn't include the... No, my mouse just died. Now we got a syntax error. We didn't load static. Come on. Of course, my mouse died. Damn it. I'm really sorry about this. It's unbelievable. Alright, so what you guys need to do is go load static. Curly brace, percent symbol, load static, percent symbol, curly brace at the top of your control underscore base.html file. I would show you, but I do not have a mouse currently. And if you guys have any questions, please leave a comment, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Nope. Oh, there we go.